And now Project Economy coverage, and a major retailer, Gottschalk's, is the latest casualty of the sagging economy, going out of business and taking local jobs and sales tax dollars with it. Today, the news came down that Gottschalk's will be liquidated. The company filed for bankruptcy in January, and a group of liquidators bought it at auction. Santa Cruz County has two Gottschalk stores, one at the Capitola Mall, the other in Watsonville. Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live in Santa Cruz with a closer look at the impact.
Well, another retail chain has fallen, and locally it means more people out of work in communities already hit hard by unemployment and fewer tax dollars for struggling cities. Shoppers heading into Gottschalk stores in Capitola and in downtown Watsonville heard the news of the department store's liquidation.
It's the last big department store that it's the, one of the first ones that Santa Cruz had, and it's an important one. It's a good place for us to shop. My father's been shopping here as long as he's 87. And
Watsonville has seen its fair share of stores closing shop. Gottschalk's has been the anchor for downtown business the past 14 years. They'll be gone by July.
I mean, it's an important piece, but it's not a huge part of our sales tax base. Some of our other stores are bigger. But on the other hand, it is important, and it will be a further blow to our tax base, and it's going to be another hit to our bottom line. So it's not good.
After a closed-door auction in bankruptcy court in Delaware, Gottschalk's liquidation will be handled by the same group that did Mervyn's in Circuit City. For many consumers, the question is, who's next?
It's really, really unfortunate. You know, it means, like for the local newspapers that Gottschalk's advertises, it just has this domino effect all the way down.
Just all these big places closing, like Gottschalk's, puts another big hole in Watsonville, the city of Watsonville, you know. And, you know, where else are we going to go? This is the only big store, really, that there is here.
I spoke with both the owner of the Capitola, the Mace Rich Company, and Bill Hance, who owns the building in Watsonville. Both tell me they have several new retailers in mind, but neither is willing to name names until a deal is finalized. Erin?
All right, Phil, thank you. Meantime, the old Mervyn spot at the Capitola Mall is already filled. Kohl's is expected to move into the site by this September.